We have found an Earth-like planet orbiting a star right next door to our sun. Pack your bags, kids. Let's go to Proxima B. Hello there, soon-to-be Proxima Centaurians. Trace here for DNews. A few weeks back, we started hearing rumors, really exciting rumors, tales of the discovery of a new planet, and then we freaked out because those rumors are true. Today, astronomers announced our closest neighbor star, Proxima Centauri, has a rocky planet orbiting in the habitable zone. Ladies and gentlemen, Proxima B. The planet is around 30% more massive than Earth and is mind-blowingly close to its star. It only takes a little over 11 days for the planet to complete a single orbit. It's 95% closer to Proxima than we are to our sun. It doesn't burn up because Proxima is a red dwarf star, so it's much cooler and smaller than our sun. The habitable zone around any star is the distance at which the planet needs to orbit that's not too hot or too cold for liquid water to exist on its surface. As far as we can tell, where there is water, there is a possibility for life. So this is why astrobiologists get excited when they find exoplanets in habitable zones. Just because a planet is in a habitable zone, though, doesn't mean that we can live there. And even though liquid water could exist on Proxima B, that doesn't mean it has any. On top of that, red dwarf stars like Proxima Centauri emit more intense X-ray flares and ultraviolet energies than our own sun does. So while we probably can't live there, it's exciting, because before 1995, we'd never confirmed a single exoplanet. For all we knew, there were no planets out there, much less one right next door, only 4.2 light years away, which is still far, but in astronomical terms is ludicrously close. So this is exciting for many reasons. First, this Proxima B is the closest exoplanet beyond our solar system, which is great. But the fact that it is Earth-sized and it orbits inside the habitable zone are both amazing. Because come on, interstellar missions, am I right? There's currently a lot of excitement for that possibility and plans in place to send spacecraft to other stars, but we need new technology. Our fastest current spacecraft would take about 80,000 years to get to Proxima Centauri, but if we could go 10% the speed of light, we'd cut that down to 50 years. We can't go that fast yet, but maybe engineers and scientists will now be inspired to figure out how to get to this new planet, especially if it's Earth-like when we get there. But that's a big if. Though the media is calling Proxima B an Earth-like world, that's not particularly accurate. Just because a world is small and rocky like Earth and orbits in the habitable zone doesn't make it an oasis fit for life. Just look at Mars and Venus. Both of these are in the habitable zone of our sun, and neither are particularly Earth-like. I already mentioned the powerful X-ray and ultraviolet radiation that Proxima B is likely subject to. Not great for biology. But also, red dwarfs are known to flare regularly, blasting any planets nearby with radiation. This means Proxima B would have to have a thick atmosphere and powerful magnetosphere to protect it from damaging space weather if life were to flourish. For now, we have no clue if it has either. And then there's the question of Proxima B's really tight orbit. When a planet orbits its star so closely, it can become tidally locked. This causes one hemisphere to constantly face the star while the other is in constant night. That's very unearth-like and can make for insane planetary weather. One side cooks while the other freezes. Look, in the end, this is still a very important and historic discovery. To have any world that just so happens to have any earthy qualities in our galactic doorstep is an incredible stroke of luck and will undoubtedly become a point of scientific interest that could inspire Earthlings to see interstellar travel as a possibility. When it comes to finding these tiny little planets, how do we know so much about them when they're so far away? Discovery News space producer Dr. Ian O'Neill explains that for you here.
The event of finding a truly habitable alien world may be a long way off, but for now we have missions like NASA's Kepler Space Telescope doing mind-blowing work detecting small worlds, big worlds, and worlds that are just plain weird.
Special thanks to Dr. Ian O'Neill for all his help with this story. We couldn't have done it without you. You are a star, man. So how do you feel about this discovery? Are you excited? Are you nervous? Do you want to go to there? Let us know in the comments, and please subscribe so you get more DNews.